Welcome to everyone. Today we are very elated and a bit nervous also to have one great teacher of India among us as an interviewee. He is an outstanding teacher, beautiful researcher, an inspiration to many minds inside and outside of the mathematics community, a great leader, a visionary, a beautiful mind, and so on. He is very close to heart of students and a foundation of motivation to us. We have learned from him how to learn. A warm welcome to Professor S. Kumaresan, our beloved Kumaresan sir. We are going to hear from him about his journey and about his wonderful, effective, magical creation, MGTS.
Thank you, Sangeeta, for the introduction.
Yes, sir. Sir, so shall we start?
Sure. I'm game. Yeah.
So my first question would be, if you were the person going to interview Professor S. Kumaresan, then what would be your first question to him?
I think you should have given this question earlier to me. Yeah, the first question would be, where did you start? And what were your goals? Did you achieve them? These are the standard questions you ask, the same question I would also ask. Because I would like to know. Yeah.
So we are having these all questions further. So we'll start from the basic. That is your childhood.
Yes. You want to know about my childhood? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir, you have done your schooling from Pachayappa's High School, Chidambaram, Tamil Nadu.
Yes.
You did your BSc and MSc in Mathematics from Annamalai University, Chidambaram, right. Tamil Nadu.
Yes. Right.
Then you did your PhD from TIFR, Mumbai.
Yeah.
So, sir, can you share some memorable incidents from your BSc days?
BSc days, yes. Something very interesting was, in BSc days, I was getting into English and Tamil literature. So I thought after my BSc, I will go for a MA, either in English literature or Tamil literature, whichever gives me job. Okay. But then, in the final year of BSc, there was something called real analysis.
Okay.
And MSc students were also there with me, senior students. They all said it's a very, very tough subject, you know, nobody understands this. Only our Professor Ganapati here knows this, nobody else knows, etc. So I like challenges, so I just started reading that. Then I found it's very easy.
Oh, really?
At least I started understanding well. So in some sense, it drew me back to mathematics. Otherwise, I would have certainly gone for some literature in Mars for my MA.
So, any special incidents about your childhood memories? Like, how were you in your maths classes in your childhood?
Childhood, let me tell you that I was very fond of reading books. So, all my elders, my great-grandfathers were also alive at the time. They used to find that when I'm reading a book, anything can happen in the house. Nothing will disturb me. People will say, they used to say that, you know, if he's reading a book, if a thief comes, kills us and takes away, Kumaresan will not know. That's the kind of focus I had. That much I remember. And but you asked something else.
Yes. Also, what about your family background?
My family background is among, I would call it lower middle class in those days. Mm-hmm. Okay. And we just had essentially enough money to carry through our life. That's it. No luxury, nothing. Yeah, we didn't have any kind of radio. We didn't have any kind of electricity. None of those things. It's just a very kind of lowest bottom. But I would still think that we were comfortable in the sense we were able to have our food. There was nothing like, you know, I didn't have to sell any tea or newspapers or anything. I still have, my parents took care of me.
So, sir, how you managed in those situations?
There is nothing like managing. And that's your life. And you didn't see, the question of managing comes, if you know there is something better and you have seen it, you have witnessed, you have experienced, then only you try to compare, okay, how can I live here, how can I manage? That question doesn't arise. It was a very lovely life. I still enjoy that.
Sir, we heard from some sources that in your college days, you saw a book and then you saw some errors in that book and then you posted a letter to the author of that book. So, sir, can you share that incident with us?
Yeah, right. That was in my first year of MSc. And that was the first time I'm on the so-called gender topology was introduced. Those days, even master's degree will not have topology. That was the first time it was being introduced in my university. Madras University, no other university had that at the time. So there was a prescribed textbook and I started reading it on my own. Then I found a lot of, there are, I would say, not great mistakes, but mistakes, okay? And like you would find in my books also, that kind of thing. That doesn't mean, no, the author does not know. It's just a man, you know. Justice escapes your mind at the time. So that kind of thing. But I am just an MSc student coming from a village background and it was an American author. So I was very thrilled. Okay. I listed all of them. Okay. And my classmates were very, very excited. Okay. That Kumarasan found mistakes in some American author book. Okay. And so they said we should write to him. And so, but then how do I write to him? Those days, like what you have inland letter, I don't know whether you guys now know there is an inland letter. It's a similar version for what is called aerogram. Okay. And in that, so about 30 things, very, very small letters, because within that I have to finish everything. So I wrote those things and sent to him. Okay. And it used to be the postage was 65 paise those days. And to give an idea about 65 paise, won't cup of tea used to cost 10 paise. So it's a 6.5 cups of tea those days. Mm-hmm. And I didn't have that money. So my classmates pulled money, each 10 paise like that. Then I sent it to him. And to give credit to the author, within about, I think less than a month's time, I got the reply from him. It was a very, really exhilarating. He accepted all my things are correct. And he said most of the things number wise, he said these are all already known, pointed out to me, or I already am aware of that. He pointed out three, these are new, I have not been pointed out, and you are right. So that gave me great confidence. That's why in my linear algebra book also I say that don't assume I am always correct, there may be mistakes. Okay, make sure you are correct, then it will give you a lot of confidence. Yeah.
Sir, as you did your PhD from TFR Mumbai, so how was your first experience in research?
Oh, first experience is research. Okay, just because before my real published paper, I did a lot of quite a few things. Okay, because I'm always curious. Even in my first year, as soon as I joined, what I did in MSc, I presented as a kind of a lecture to in front of many top class mathematicians. People will continue to do and have some kind of tangential acquaintance even with the TAFR, you will hear the name C.P. Ramanujam. And he was very excited with my finding. Okay, see, so all of you know axiom of choice and Hausdorff's maximality principle, Zahn's lemma, well-ordering principle, these are all equivalent statements. Okay, they're all axioms. You assume one, you can derive the other. So my idea was those days was if something is proved using one, can I prove it using the other? So the construction of non-measurable sets usually is proved using axiom of choice. So I tried to see whether I can prove it using well-ordering principle, which I did, and which was very much appreciated. But later we found that somebody has already done that. That was my very first experience in my first year in TAFR. Yeah. And after that, I think there are a lot of small things which we did, but yeah.
Sir, any memorable incidents of TFR days?
There are just too many. There are just too many. Mm. See, the first thing is, See, as I said, I come from a small village. Even today, my village, with all this, what you call population explosion, my village is shrunk in size. But most often villages might happen. But my even at those days, it used to be about 300 people. That's it. And when I joined Anomaly University, then I found that I was extremely good. Meaning, in my own perception, of course, okay?
Yes, sir. You had first rank in your university, right?
And my teachers also said that. In fact, I'll come to that a little later.
Okay, sir.
And so, in some sense, I mean, my head was swollen, possibly. Still, I was grounded, but I mean, I thought myself a bit too much. So when I joined TFR, I found that there are people who are much, much better than I am.
Okay.
Okay. So that brought me down more to down to earth. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so then I learned the art of, I mean, talking mathematics to a lot of people there. That's one thing which TFR taught me well. That is, at any point of time, anywhere, okay, even at the tea table, even when you go to the take your leak at the loo, then also discuss mathematics, this kind of thing, okay? At any point of time, it just occurs to you, then you don't kind of look for what is the place, what is the situation. No. It is a curiosity. I have to ask, I have to discuss. So I discuss. That kind of attitude, yes. Okay. This is one thing which I could not forget. So if you enjoy it in MTTS, you should thank TA for that.
Yes, sir. We have enjoyed a lot of that.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Tamogna, can you share the screen?
Wow.
So, sir, did you remember this?
Of course, how can I forget?
Yes, sir. Exactly, sir. You become the first. Yes, sir. Yes. You become the first Indian mathematician to get INSA, Indian National Science Academy Teachers Award in 2013. So, right. Sir, do you want to say something about this?
What do I want to say? No, I think I was very happy. That's all I could say. But I could remember when I went there was a banquet dinner at the time. There were some officials who were with the INSA, and they came and met me at the dinner time, and they said something. There were a lot of applications for that, and when they went through mine, okay, then they knew they do not look any further. Okay, that's the word, more or less they said that. That was somewhat very flattering, but yes. I was very glad about that. Somebody at least recognized. Okay. Because I think it was Professor Subhash Bhatt who recently passed away. And he was the one who said something. See, now everywhere only the research and publication is put on pedestal. Much respected. He said, you brought back the teaching, the credit it deserves, the respect it deserves. That's the word you used. And I think this is a sign of such a recognition. Yes.
Yes, sir. We feel that. I mean, teaching, for teaching, you have done so much things. We will know by time because we include those questions here. Okay. Okay. Next question or next.
So, sir, you have told us about your fascination towards Tamil literature. And also you have told your direction, how you chose maths upon Tamil literature. So, just a small question, that can you recite something in Tamil?
Oh, yeah. See, as you know, I used to be very good in my, what do you call, primary school days, great memory. But now, later when I started thinking, then I decided not to memorize anything. Try to understand what it says. So, I don't think I can just like that do that. But I can quote bits and pieces of Kural, which I like. One is, Enniya Enniyaangu Eiduvar, Enniyar Thinniyar Agapperin. If you allow me, I'll just show that. I had done that. Yeah, this is the one I'm quoting. In fact, most often when students ask me, Tamil students ask me to write something, I use this. You can see that what they seek, they will achieve as they seek. If those who seek are made of firm resolve. It says that, you know, you should be dedicated and you should try to do, and you should not, you should have perseverance and tenacity to reach your goal. This is really one of the motivating quotes for me. The other one which I really okay. like is this.
Yeah.
The other one is Ulluvadellam Uyarvul. It says that, you know, whatever you think, you should think for the best. Fervently aspire for the best. Even if you fail, it's still as good as succeeding.
Okay. Very nice.
Yeah. There are two others, but there is another one which I like. Akkam Adrivinaich Sellum Asavila Ukkam Udayan Uray. Wealth, success, fame on their own will find the way to reach those with unflagging fervor. So I don't want to quote more. There is one more, but it's enough. These are the quotes which really I live by.
Thank you, sir.
And these were written about 2000 years ago with no reference to religion. Okay. It's really pure Ramana. Okay, because some religion is touted as a way of life, but Kural actually teaches way of life. Yeah.
Sir, you are a great mathematician. So, sir, we want to know from you how a research mind works.
So, the basic thing for any scientist, nothing to do with mathematics or in general, for science, or in general, even for if you want to be a thinker, you should be curious. You should be curious. If somebody says, okay, you should be curious, what does it mean? Okay, does it relate to something which I had already learned? Or can I get something? Almost like a baniya. Okay, can I get some benefit out of that? Okay, this kind of curiosity should be there. Okay, it should not be kind of a, you know, or like a religious dictum. You said that, so it must be true, I accept it. No. Okay. True. A sense of what I call a healthy irreverence should be there. You know, all of you know what is meant by reverend, right? I rever you. You rever your teachers, you rever your guru, you rever your grandfather, parents, or big elders, great leaders. Okay. But even there should be a healthy irreverence in the sense that you don't want to be irreverent. But what you want is just because he is big, you should not accept that. That's what Gautam Buddha said. In the MTTS souvenir, you will see Gautam Buddha's teaching. It clearly says that do not take it, assume the truth just because your teacher said or your parents said or your guru said or whoever. Okay. After examining, testing it, convincing yourself, then only you accept. I think that's the first thing any scientist should have. After that, of course, one should have a pattern recognition. And you want to return, you know, when you want to have a pattern recognition, then you should be ready to kind of observe. Your sense of observation should be very important. Only when you observe, then you see the pattern. Oh, this I have seen somewhere. Then you try to relate. Then the later thing is, once you see the pattern, then you try to see whether there is any kind of single principle or general theory or in mathematics language, any theorem which explains them, all of them. Like as a very simplistic approach will be 2 chalks plus 3 chalks, 2 bananas plus 3 bananas, 2 elephants plus 3 elephants. You know, 5 of that. Instead, now you see a pattern, 2 plus 3, you don't know what is 2, you don't know 3, but you know 2 plus 3 is 5. You formulate it. This kind of pattern, you should observe, recognize the pattern and try to see why such a pattern exists. Is there any single phenomenon which explains? Okay. Later, next thing is in other sciences, they will try to kind of, they cannot prove it. They can only verify. They will conduct more experiments to see whether the phenomenon, the principle explains the new phenomenon also. Whereas in mathematics, you have a fantastic tool, namely a proof. So what we proved, Aman? Well, if it's a correct proof, it will be a proof forever. Unlike, okay, whenever people come, gravitation's interpretation, propagation of light, or the nature of light keep changing. Okay, that's nothing wrong. Okay, that's the nature of things. You have to accept it. I'm just saying that. Yeah, because if there are viewers who are from other sciences, should not think I'm trying to disparage them. No, that's the nature of their thing. That's the correct thing they can do. Yeah.
So the way you think in mathematics is really appreciable. So sir, did you used to think in this way since your childhood?
Childhood, I do not know whether, see, in childhood, usually, I was always curious. Whenever something happened, I tried to understand. Okay. And that was there. But this kind of real kind of thing, probably when I started learning real analysis in my BSc. Okay. And more than that, when I tried to teach real analysis to my classmates, because they all found it difficult. Even my seniors used to come to me. When I thought it was very easy. When I was explaining, they didn't understand. You could see their eyes. Okay. Then I tried to understand why they don't understand. Then usually I found there is always some kind of a preconceived notion or a mental block. Okay. Then I tried to remove that. Okay. Then I tried to come up with examples. That's when I started thinking of real life examples also. You see that in my lectures, I always come up with analogies and real life examples.
Yes, sir. Exactly.
Okay. Because it opens your mind. All of you might have seen pictures. Okay. In one perspective, it will be a old witch. In another perspective, it will be a very beautiful young woman. There are a lot of such optical illusions, pictures you might have seen. What does that mean? You have to have that perspective, then you will see the old witch. You change the perspective, you will see. So I found this kind of real analogies or real life examples makes you think in that perspective. It's something like look at in this direction. Then you will find it. Instead of saying, look here, it will find it. You simply say, look at in this direction, then you will find it. So this kind of examples give that direction. So that's what I found out when I was teaching my teaching skill improved thanks to my classmates of BSc. Yeah. Because I tried to understand their difficulty and tried to understand, yeah.
Sir, what were the areas of mathematics for which you took it as a main subject?
See, my first love was always geometry. Okay. I was good in mathematics in general. I can tell you when I really started liking mathematics was in my third standard. I had a cousin and she was 2 or 3 years older to me. And third standard, we just got the book. Those days, I think third standard is the first time then they introduced the fractions. Okay, so she had learned it. She was in fifth or sixth standard. So she taught me using that book. Then I started reading the book on my own and started solving problems. And till my high school, as soon as I buy math book, within a month or two, I would solve all problems. I read on my own and did that. So that is the first time I really took a liking for mathematics. Till then, I was reasonably good in everything. So I was doing it. That's it. But a special liking was, I should thank my cousin, Gunavati, for that. And the second thing was, when you came to those days, today's ninth standard, those days, I think it's called fourth form or something. And at that time, the so-called Euclidean geometry was introduced. Okay. And that intrigued me. Because you have something like axiom. The word axiom, I did not know those days. It was in Tamil. Okay. And after that, whatever you want, you have to derive from the axioms or whatever the results you had proved earlier. Okay. These are nice to say these days. Okay. At my age, it's so many years of experience, 60 years of experience. Okay. Assuming though from those days, it's all easy to say that. Okay. Not 60 days, years. Okay. 55 years. Okay. But those days, it was very amazing for me. Okay, that's the one thing which really more or less I made up my mind that I will pursue mathematics in my around 9th or 10th standard because of geometries. And that's why in all my things I still like to think, because that's my first love with mathematics. So I still like to think mostly in terms of whether I could do a picture, whether I could do something like that. Yes.
Okay. Yes, sir. That is what helps us a lot. I mean, students like us, we get a lot of help from that, because if we see the things you are teaching, then that helps us to think also.
Yeah, right.